Hey guys, it's Hannah, back from another video. So yeah, today I'm just gonna be having a little chit chat, you know, about quarantine and that. And basically, I just feel like we shouldn't be bums. Like, people are saying, oh, I'm so bored. And I just feel like you shouldn't be that bored. Like, you've got shit to do. I know everyone's kind of like, knows they have shit to do, but it's shit that they don't wanna do. But I'm gonna help you guys, you know, get it done. So yeah, first of all, I've just got a little list, well, a big list on my phone of things to cover. So first of all, most people, I guess, watching this will either be working full time or at uni. So if you're at uni like me, you've got uni work to do. Your assignments are there, they're waiting. Because remember, like, you're not on a holiday, you're not finished uni. This is online uni. We're still at uni, guys. So yeah, I think I've literally been trying to do, even literally if it's 1 hour a day. Like, I know it sounds very small, but it's better than saying, yeah, I'm gonna do like 6 hours today, and then you sit there and don't do shit. Like, what I do a lot of the time is I'll do like 3 20-minute intervals, because I've got really bad concentration. On a 20-minute timer, put my phone on plane, airplane mode, and then literally just concentrate for 20 minutes in something done every day. It's not like a total waste of the day. This is a great opportunity to do things that you always put off, things that you always think, oh, like, I should do it, but yeah, I don't have time, I've got this and that. Whereas now, you haven't got anything to do, you're not going anywhere, you don't have other appointments or arrangements. Like, this is a great opportunity to do that. So things such as literally like washing your makeup brushes, I'm not gonna lie, I don't wash my makeup brushes often than I should, and I say that with my chest, because who does, who washes them every single week without fail? Not me. Is like cleaning your room, like if it's like a proper clearer of your wardrobe, like, this is a great opportunity to get it done. Like, just if you just say a goal for the next day, like tomorrow is literally just clean my room, just set one goal, and then by the end of that day you can be like, okay, like, I've actually achieved something, so I haven't been a complete bum. So doing things you always put off, for example, like starting a YouTube channel if you haven't, or things that you've always sort of wanted to do, this is a great opportunity to start. Things that you've always said, oh, I don't really have time, like, you have the time now to do things like that. Start a YouTube channel. For me, like, I'm just trying to be more consistent and upload more because I've actually got the time and I don't actually have an excuse anymore. So the next thing is broaden your knowledge. So this is a great opportunity. So if, obviously, I've said if you're doing like uni work or work, you're not doing that for the whole day. Uni work, I only do maybe like 1 to 2 hours a day, and something, and I'm achieving something, but you've got a lot of the time left of the day to be keeping your brain active by broadening your knowledge. For example, like reading up on like things that you, again, things that you'd want to do but you haven't really had the time before. So I'm reading a book at the moment, and this is just about procrastination and stopping procrastination, and then once I finish that, I'm gonna start on books about investing. So like, learn something new. That it's never a waste of time, basically, to learn something new. Like, knowledge is power, as people say. Even if it's like, I don't know, like, learn to code. That sounds boring as hell to me, but some people, that might be something that they enjoy doing. I don't know, like, learn a new language. Like, there's like apps and stuff like Duolingo, even if it's like, and there's little games you can do just to like keep your brain active and like learn a new language. That can help in a lot of jobs if you can translate or you can speak another language. That's really helpful. The next thing, sort of branch off that again, is reading. So in terms of broadening your knowledge, even if it's not learning a language, something like that, a certain skill, just reading. So it can be fiction, non-fiction books, just reading anything. Again, I feel like it's just keeping your brain active and occupied, like it's something to do as well. And I feel like, obviously, reading as well, it just helps like your literacy and your understanding and knowledge and stuff. So I feel like reading's always good, and again, you can learn something new depending on if the book is fictional or non-fictional. And like, I feel like still try and keep some sort of structure to your day. Like, don't just do whatever, because at the end of the day, you have to think, whenever this quarantine ends, whether it's 3 weeks, 3 months, you're still eventually gonna have to get back into routine. So it's probably easier to sort of keep it sort of still structured. I'm not saying wake up at 6 a.m. every day still, like, you don't have to do that, but just sort of keep a sort of structure, even if it's every day wake up at 10, every day wake up at 11, wake up at 11, like, just keep it sort of structured and find out what works for you. Like, for me, I like to wake up between like 8 and 10, and I like to sort of do my work in the middle of the day, have like my productive hours in the middle of the day, and then from about 4 p.m. I'm literally just chilling till bedtime. so still have that balance, like you still have a lot of time to like relax and just, you know, let loose. Like just do, spread your arms, spread your legs, do whatever you want. But like, I think it's just important to have, even if it's one productive hour a day, like you've still done something. Don't just be a bum. So when it now comes to the end of quarantine and it's like, oh, people have achieved stuff, what have you achieved apart from you've literally been rolling in your bed and gained weight? Like, honey, like, do something. I'm not gonna lie, I put my weight, but I'm you know, I'm broadening my knowledge, I'm doing my uni work, so it's okay. So yeah, literally just have some sort of structure to your day. Don't just fully let loose. Still enjoy yourself, still have time for yourself, but keep it sort of a little bit structured. And the next thing, home workouts. Obviously you gymmers, I feel like us gymmers, yeah, it's burning us the most. Home workouts is not the same, first of all, but it's a home workout. Like, you haven't really got an excuse right now. It's free, first of all. You're not paying for a membership. You don't have to. You get there, you can wear whatever you want. You can do it naked if you want. You can be jumping up and down naked in your room. But literally, you've got no excuse. Even if it's like a 20-minute little sesh, like upper body, legs, like you can literally do it without any equipment. So I literally couldn't find any like dumbbells, because when I went to buy it, I basically fumbled the bag, so I didn't find any dumbbells. So I've only got two resistance bands, a long and a short one, and I can honestly do it without. And also this thing, yeah. This is your new kettlebell. Get one of these, yeah. It's not that heavy, but it's great to use, like, instead of a kettlebell. Keeping your brain active, getting creative, thinking like, how can I use what I've got at home to like make gym equipment? Obviously we've got like one form of exercise a day, like still go on your morning walks or afternoon walks. And right now the weather is really nice, so I feel like this is a great opportunity to literally get out of the house, go on like a long walk. You still need to get some fresh air, you know, like clear your head and stuff, like it's really good, and keep active. Also, a lot of people, I'm quite privileged because I work in a supermarket, I work in retail, and obviously a supermarket is an essential workplace, so I still have a job, I'm still employed, and I still go to work. So like, I feel like I'm privileged in that sense, whereas some people I understand would have lost their jobs, or they don't go to work at the moment, so money might be a little bit tight. To think of new ways to make money from home, example, selling stuff on Depop. I know that obviously might be a little bit techie, because obviously like going out, post office and the whole thing, you can do like online surveys, like there's just different ways. But guys, do your own research, do your Googles, as Melissa's wardrobe would say. Matched betting, I'm not really going to talk too much on that, but do your own research. But I have done that before, and I use Team Profit. I'll put the link down below to what I use, but I did make quite a lot of money from it. Again, do your own research, it's not normal betting, it's matched betting. But again, use my link below if you're interested. Googles before you try and come and say Hannah said, because that's not my problem. I feel like it's very important to just sort of not get too wound up like with the whole social media thing, because like so much going around and it's sort of overwhelming. New article every day there's something new. So I feel like it's very important to literally just focus on, you know, clearing your mind and not overthinking, because I feel like it can be a very dark place for some people, especially because everyone's staying at home. So yeah, you also have to sort of like not look too much into social media and all the negative aspects and see the benefits. So some benefits, first of all, we're saving money. Like, you're not going anywhere. What are you spending money on? Like, you're just not spending money traveling, I guess. You're not spending money on food out. I guess you can order in still, sort of, but it's just a lot of money is saved by staying in your yard, basically. So that's obviously one thing. You can save money, use that to invest, just save it, whichever you, but saving money is also always a positive thing. We're never really gonna get an opportunity like this. I know it's not really fun, I guess, but like, we're never gonna have time like this where to actually sit at home. Like, when everyone gets back to normal, to real work, I feel like I don't want to have taken this for granted, and it's important to make sure you come out of it with something. Even if it's something small, just knowing, okay, even if I've read in the 3 weeks, however long quarantines, I've read one book, like just like something, just having achieved something, I feel like it's just very good for your mind, you know? Like, there's no point working yourself up about something that's out of your control. All we can do is do our bit and stay at home, but I feel like it's important not to overthink it and just get yourself worked up, because it ends. But as a whole, we can't control the whole situation. So I feel like this is an important time to literally just focus on yourself, focus on you, obviously relax. Like, we've got a lot of free time to literally just chill, but also like focus on bettering yourself, like your skincare, things that you don't really have time to do. Obviously you're at home all day, so you can like not really wear makeup when you don't need to. Like, just focus on yourself and your well-being, and FaceTime, call your friends and your family. As obviously some people may be struggling, and just check on loved ones. I feel like, don't check on them physically, call them, FaceTime them, because it's a very weird situation. I'll just do this quick little video, just, you know, saying how I feel. But yeah, basically the main takeaway points is, you know, do something with your time. You've got a lot of free time, stay positive, stay happy, and yeah, do something. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little video, and I'll catch you guys in my next one. Happy isolation, happy quarantine, guys. Bye.